I'm extremely excited. This is one of the most important conferences, in my view, that's occurred not just this year, but in recent, my memory at least, in terms of advancing not just the cause of conservation, but also really about the productivity of agriculture here in the United States.
Improving the nation's soil health was the focal point of the 2014 National Conference on Cover Crops and Soil Health, held earlier this year in Omaha, Nebraska. The event was sponsored by the Howard G. Buffett Foundation and was live-streamed to over 220 USDA and extension locations throughout the nation. Concurrent with the national conference, individual states hosted forums where soil health and cover crops were also discussed.
Today we conducted the forum on soil health and cover crops in Texas, Zone 5. We had four of these meetings simultaneously across the zone. This one happened to be here in Temple, Texas at the Grassland Soil and Water Research Lab.
Farmers and ranchers at this workshop watched the national video feed and later discussed local soil health issues and opportunities.
Soil health in general, I think, is a great thing because, you know, if you look around where I live, if you look around, there's not many earthworms and there's a lot of bottom land. I see people are always there. They're doing the farming thing they tell us not to do. They're tilling a lot of land. And there are some things that you don't see a lot of no more, like birds, animals, stuff around the country you don't see anymore. And that's one thing I'd like to see come back. I think that's great. Those of us here, we can come together and see the forum, and then we can talk about what's going on, and you can learn from guys who are actually around you that's doing it.
I think it's a wonderful idea. I liked the gentleman who spoke about bringing back the endowment of our soil, that we've depleted it and it's time to bring it back.
Today, part of why I'm doing all this is I want to be a beacon of hope for the Blackland Prairie and Texas so that we eliminate the "you can't do that here's," and so I'm happy that we had a good turnout today of people that can hear that there's hope to farm in different ways and build the soil back to be sustainable.
We had both indoor and outdoor activities. The indoor, of course, was just a really good discussion, but the outdoor activities, we really focused on what's called a soil health assessment. And that soil health assessment's helping a producer get a shovel in their hands and get a hole dug and then start looking at the chemical, the physical, and the biological properties of those soils. It was exciting because a lot of people, they really had some good observations, and hopefully the indicators that we showed them can help them decide where to start with the soil health management system.
A presentation by Bo Brooks, a district conservationist for NRCS, underscored the basic principles of soil health.
The most important thing about my presentation was that you got to remember it takes a systems approach for soil health to work, that there's not one magic bullet to soil health. You know, cover crops is a hot topic, but it covers three parts of the five principles, so it's pretty good, but it takes more than just one thing. It's got to be a systems approach to soil health.
Local agriculture producers also played a major role in the forum.
I think it worked out great, and especially being able to see, you know, having that producer panel and seeing actual farmers besides, you know, just NRCS personnel trying to preach to people, that it really gets, you know, people real or more interested in having, you know, some local input or some local farmers, their input on stuff that they've been trying.
I think it's a great opportunity. This is a really good time for producers to voice their opinions, to let us know what the challenges they see coming in front of them. Just give us some feedback for NRCS, Extension, Research, everyone to hear their concerns and then try to, you know, accommodate their needs. This forum will definitely make a difference in the way I think farming goes in the state of Texas for the next several years.
To find out more about cover crops and the basic and benefits of soil health, contact your local USDA NRCS field office or visit www.nrcs.usda.gov.